It was somber as family members and friends converged for the final send-off of their loved ones. Chris Intege, Cinderella Butesi and their two children, Jaden Alvin Nsibambi and Jenna Flores Intege, were involved in a fatal accident that killed 9 people on Masaka Road last Friday. The burial ceremony started off with prayers at St. James Church in Gwafo. As the funeral service vans brought in the bodies of the deceased from the late Ntege's paternal home in Gwafo, where they spent the night. The caskets containing the bodies of the deceased were then brought into church by the pallbearers who were in charge of the burial ceremony. Alice Senoga, mother of the late Chris Intege, remembered her son as a great pillar of the family. Amid tears, family members and friends shared the agony they've gone through ever since the tragedy happened.
We are so suddenly. We are down, but we pray that God heals us, because it's a deep wound.
You have done so many things, it is very hard to recollect. But the memories are too many. Family, we are very grateful that you had to nurture such a very, I would say, beautiful girl. This is how Teke. She has given him happiness, I do believe, at the time this incident happened. Very happy family. That's what gives us strength. They were together. Yeah, they were together. They loved themselves. And what I can say that Mukama Yebaziwe, for that very time, that very short time he has given us. It sounds short, but it is worth a lifetime of experience.
Mass was presided over by the Bishop of Mukono, Right Reverend Enos Chitokagodo, who asked family members of the deceased to pray for God's mercy to overcome the grief.
In such a situation, let's put our hope in that one who doesn't fear that
funny.
Let's put our hope in that one who stands
for
special, those who are brave. That's why he says, be strong. I've overcome the world. But he also said, I believe in peace. I pray for the peace of God. I pray for the peace of God that exceeds everything to be with you.
The bodies of the deceased were later laid to their final resting place at Namaiwa in Nachisunga sub-county. Report compiled by Joanita Nakate for the news.